So welcome to the basic thermodynamics class. So in the first chapter, we completed up to the fundamentals of thermodynamics, and the second part is the perfect gas laws. So in this class, we discuss about the Charles' law, Boyle's law, and the problems related to the Charles' law and the Boyle's law. So today's class, before going to discuss about the perfect gas laws, first we have to discuss main objectives of this class are the definition of the perfect gas, Boyle's laws, and the Charles' law. Before going to the Boyle's law, first we discuss about the what is in a vapor. So what is in a vapor means a vapor is nothing but the evaporation of a liquid is partially, then it is called in a vapor. Just if you take a container, pour the water and just heat the container. After some time, the vapors are coming out from the water. That is called as a vapor. So the here what is a liquid? Water is in a liquid. So if the evaporation of a liquid is partial, then it is called in a vapor. So a vapor contains the particles of a liquid in suspension. Example, steam, carbon dioxide, ammonia as a vapor. As a vapor becomes dry when it is completely evaporated. So when the vapors become dry, when it is completely evaporated. So define vapor means if the evaporation of a liquid is partially, then it is called in a vapor. Examples are the steam, carbon dioxide, ammonia as a. If the dry vapor is further heated, the process is called the superheated, and the vapor is called the superheated vapor. So if the vapor is further on heating, if the water is heated continuously, then the vapor becomes a dry, then the dry vapor is called as a superheating. So we are increasing the temperature more, then the vapor becomes a dry. Then the dry vapor goes on increasing, that the vapor, it is called as a superheated vapor. So the behavior of a superheated vapor is similar to that of a perfect. Coming to the gas. So the gas is nothing but the state of substance whose evaporation from liquid state is complete. So it's called a gas. So the term gas is applied to in a particular phase of a pure substance. So particular and which the gas is fills in the system boundary, and there is no change of phase takes place. So the term gas is nothing but a particular phase of a pure substance, which will fill the system boundary and no change of a phase takes place, or it is contemplated. That is a gas. If such a phase changes could be easily contemplated, if the term vapor must be applied. Term vapor. So coming to the perfect gas. So the perfect gas is a one which remains a gaseous state and obeys the gaseous law at all the temperature. So is called as a perfect gas. So coming to the perfect gas is nothing but one which remains in a gaseous state and obeys all the laws at all the temperatures is called as a perfect gas. So perfect gas are characterized by the force attractions or the any repulsions between the molecules. Force repulsion or the repulsions between the molecules. That means that the volume occupied by the molecules and infinitely small to compare with that of a gas. So perfect gas is in a gaseous form. So when you say it is a perfect gas, the perfect gas always remains in a gaseous form at all the temperatures and follows all the gas laws at all the temperatures and then pressures. So some of the important gas laws are the Boyle's law and Charles' law. So a gas which is assumed to obey the characteristic gas equation. So characteristic gas equation is discussed in the next class. So at a constant specific heat is called as a ideal gas or the perfect gas. So you all know under the constant specific heat. So constant specific heat at specific heat at constant pressure and specific heat at constant volume. So can anyone say what is the specific heat at constant volume? So constant volume. So it is defined as nothing but the amount of the heat required. Amount of the heat required to raise the temperature of 1 kg of a gas by 1 degree Celsius or 1 degree Kelvin. That means that the heat is supplied at a constant volume is called a specific heat at constant volume. The heat supplied at a constant pressure is called a specific heat at constant pressure. Constant pressure. So perfect gases are often referred as a permanent ideal gas. So in the perfect gas, molecules occupy the infinitial space and there exists a no force attraction between the molecules. So we know that is it. So the total thermal energy of the molecules is only the kinetic energy. So change in total energy is directly proportional to the absolute temperature of the. So the laws of the perfect gas. So the behavior of the perfect gas undergoing any change in pressure, volume and temperature is governed by Boyle's law, Charles' law and Agnold's law. So in this class we discuss about the Boyle's law and Charles' law. Boyle's law, Charles' law. In the next class we will discuss about the Agnold's law and Avogadro's number. So we discuss about now the Boyle's law. So what is the Boyle's law is stated? So the relation between the pressure and volume when the temperature remains a constant, so this is called as Boyle's law. So Boyle's scientists who conducted the experiments by keeping such a temperature as a constant, both the pressure and volume are inversely proportional to each other. So if pressure is inversely proportional to volume, means if pressure is increasing, the volume is goes on decreasing, or vice versa, if volume is increasing, the pressure is decreasing. So at constant pressure, the pressure varies inversely proportional to the volume of the gas. So if pressure at here, the main thing is that he is keeping as the temperature as a constant. So the temperature as a constant means as the pressure is varying as a inversely proportional to the volume of the gas. Other words, if the volume is increased by the 2 times, so here the volume is inversely proportional to the pressure. So automatically the pressure comes the half of the initial volume, half of the initial volume. So P is inversely proportional to 1 by V. So PV is equal to constant. PV is equal to. So here is a one example for the Boyle's law. So here the one person is touches the boundary in 1 minute. So how many times he touches the boundary? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So in 1 minute, the person touches the or hits the boundary in 8 times. So another person touches the boundary. Here we are increasing the distance, but keeping the time as a constant. So how much distance he cover? How much distance? Here we are doubling the distance, but we are keeping as a time as a constant. So how many times he touches the boundary? 1, 2, 3, 4. So he touches the boundary 4 times. He touches the boundary 4 times. So from these two, how is the telling? So number of hits per time is inversely proportional to the distance covered. So if you double the distance, number of hits are less. So in the first case, see this here. In the first case, he touches the boundaries only 8 times because the distance is more. In the second case, he touches the boundary in 16 times because the distance is less. So I'm explaining this. So please listen. So see, from starting onwards. So a person touches the boundary in how many times? In 1 minute. So let us count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So in 1 minute, the person touches the boundary in 8 times. Now consider that the same person touches the boundary with the same speed, but we are increasing the distance, double the distance. Here, doubling the distance. So when we double the distance, the person touches the boundary is also decreases. So previous case, he touches the boundary in 16 times. Here now we are increasing the distance more. So 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So we are doubling the distance. So he touches the boundary is less. So when compare the two cases, here the distance is more. So the number of hits are less. Here the distance is less. Number of hits of the boundary is more. So from this we can say that the number of hits per time is inversely proportional to the distance covered. Here we are keeping as a speed as a constant. Number of hits per time is inversely proportional to the distance covered. So in both the cases, we are keeping as a speed as a constant, or vice versa also. So distance covered is inversely proportional to the number of hits per time as the speed remaining constant. In both the cases, the speed is remaining constant only. So in the first case, the distance is small. So the person touches the boundary number of times. So in the first case, he touches the boundary in 16 times. In the second case, if your distance is double the distance compared to the first, so number of hits are decreased. Because the distance is inversely proportional to the number of hits per time. So this is the example. This is easy to understand about the Boyle's law. So Boyle's law also, what is the Boyle's law is also temperature telling. As the speed remaining constant means, here they are keeping the temperature as a constant, and the pressure is inversely proportional to the volume, or volume is inversely proportional to the pressure. As the pressure increases, the volume decreases, or vice versa, volume increases, pressure decreases. In both the conditions, we are keeping as a temperature as a constant. C1 is the example of a Boyle's law in terms of a kinetic energy. As a gas is enclosed in a container, which increases the pressure. As the pressure is increasing, the volume is decreasing. When the pressure is increasing, the volume is decreasing, and we are keeping as a temperature as a constant. So by taking these values, we can draw that the PV diagram. P as a x-axis, V as a volume as a y-axis. If the pressure is go on increasing, the volume is decreasing. V1 to V2. Volume is go on decreasing. But the pressure P into V is equal to constant. And any cases, if the pressure is 1, volume is 6 meter cube. So the product PV is equal to 6. In second case, if the pressure is 2 and the volume is a 3 meter cube, the product PV is equal to 6. It states that the product of the pressure and volume is constant in all the cases. Pressure and volume is a constant. So Boyle's law in terms of kinetic energy, we know that in terms of as external pressure is increasing, internal pressure is increasing. There means the number of hits are increasing. So that the number of particles remains the constant, that the volume decreases. As the external pressure is increasing, the volume decreases. As the pressure increases, volume decreases. Or vice versa. As output pressure is decreases, input pressure also has to decreases. Or output pressure decreases, as input pressure also has to decreases. In that, the number of hits per time also decreases. So number of hits also decreases, means as the pressure is decreasing, that the volume is increasing. Volume is increasing. In this figure, we are keeping as a temperature as a constant, and the pressure is 1 to 2. So the pressure is goes on increasing. The pressure goes on increasing, that the volume is goes on decreasing. Volume is goes on decreasing. So these states that the volume of the gas is inversely proportional to the pressure, keeping as a temperature as a constant. So these law, this Boyle's law holds good only for the for temperature constant for a particular gas. So PV is equal to constant. So Boyle's law. So P1 to P2, V1 to V2. If the it changes from state 1 to state 2, P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2. P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2, and the shape of the graph is a rectangular hyperbola. Two states of the gases are related. P1 V1 is equal to P constant. P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2 is equal to constant. So coming to the second law is in a Charles law. So Charles law is Charles was another scientist who conducted his experiments, and tell that is a what he told that the for the Charles law, the distance covered is directly proportional to the speed. Distance covered, as we double the distance, as we want to cover the distance more, we have to increase our speed also. This is nothing but the Charles law. So Charles law, what is the Charles law? Tells that if the temperature increases, the kinetic energy also increases, and the number of hits per unit increases. So the pressure is constant, the volume is increases. So if you make a pressure as a constant by increasing the temperature is directly proportional to the volume, or vice versa. If the temperature decreases, the volume also decreases. So it states that the volume of the given mass is directly varies with its absolute temperature at constant pressure. So mathematically we are writing as a P is equal to constant. So V is directly proportional to T. So removing the proportionality constant, we will put as a C. So V is equal to CT. As the volume is increasing, if you double the volume, the temperature is also double. If you triple the volume, the temperature also triple. Or if you kept the V as a constant, pressure is directly proportional to T. P is equal to okay, we will move to the next slide. Some video problem is there. Okay, I will remove this one.
Now, what happens if he is running at a speed double of this speed? Now, let's count the number of times he hits the boundaries in the same time. That is in 1 minute only. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 13, 14, 15, 16. So when he was running at a speed which was double the initial speed, he touched the boundaries double number of times. Now we give him a condition. We say that he can touch the boundaries 8 times only when he is running at double the speed. How is that possible? Since now he is running at double the initial speed, so if he has to touch the boundaries 8 times only, that will only be possible if he covers a greater distance. And how great the distance, or how big the distance should it be? Since now he is running at double the speed, so now he should cover double the original distance. So now he has double the distance to cover in the same time. That is in 1 minute only. Let's count the number of times he hits the boundary. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So if he is running at double the speed, in order to touch the boundaries the same number of times, that is the initial number of times, he has to cover double the original distance. So let's compare. So now the person is running at double the speed. So in order to cover the distance, that is in order to touch the boundaries the same number of times, if he is running at double the speed, he has to cover a greater distance. So here you see it touched the boundaries at the same time.
Next one is the Charles law. So before going to this animation, just I'll tell one example like a Boyle's law. So for Charles law, a person is running at a speed to touch the boundary in 1 minute. So the person touches the boundary in 8 times. So the same person, when he is running with a double speed compared to the initially, he touches the boundary in 1 minute because he is increasing the speed. So it in the same time with increasing the speed, the person touches the boundary also double times. Means previously it is 8 times, now it becomes as a 16 times. Explaining once again. So a person is running at a speed with some distance, the same distance, so he hits the boundary. So we draw the one line. So he travels that line in 1 minute. So 8 times. Travels that line in 1 minute 8 times. So the same person, if he increase his speed compared to the initial, he touches the boundary in 1 minute 16 times because he is increasing his speed. So here what we can tell that whatever the distance covered is depends upon the speed. So greater the speed, the greater the distance. Lesser the speed, lesser the distance. Here the distance is directly proportional to the speed. So Charles also states that a constant pressure. Here see that we are keeping as a pressure as a constant. So you see that the pressure symbol 1.5 as a remains constant, it is not moving. And as a temperature is a varying. At constant pressure, the volume of the given gas. So observe that the volume of the given gas, if you observe that the temperature is at 250, goes on increasing, because the volume also is goes on increasing. So the pressure versus temperature is increasing like this. So mathematically we can write as a volume is directly proportional to the T. So we can remove the proportionality constant by putting a constant. So V is equal to CT. So we can write as a V divided by T equal to C. So here the T is an absolute pressure. Here is an important point. Here T is an absolute pressure. If they given in a degree centigrade, we have to convert into the absolute pressure by adding the 273. By adding that 273, then it becomes in terms of a Kelvin. It is called an absolute pressure. So at a constant pressure also, two ends states and the relatively given by the equation V1 by T1 is equal to T2. So if we are taking that the pressure is a constant, is a graph look like the parallel to the x-axis. Here that both the pressure P1 is equal to P2. Both the pressure P is equal to P2. Here is what is the telling? If the pressure of the gas is constant, then the volume is directly proportional to the temperature. Volume is directly proportional to the temperature. So here P1 is equal to P2 and V1 is increasing. V1 is equal to increasing. Statement is also consider a gas changes its states from state 1 to state 2 for the Charles law. It's nothing but that the two end states are related by a V1 by T1 is equal to V2 by. So this law can also be defined as by putting as a volume of the gas as a constant. So absolute pressure of a given gas is directly proportional to the absolute pressure at constant volume. So here in this case, the Charles is putting as a volume as a constant. Next. So this state is also called as a Glasius law. So mathematically we write it V is equal to constant. The pressure is directly proportional to temperature. So proportionality constant we are removing and putting as a constant. Here also what they are saying as the pressure increases, the temperature also increases. Where C is a constant of proportionality constant, P by T is equal to constant. This is the graph. So here this is a volume is constant. So it is a parallel to the y-axis and P1 P2. So between the two end states, 1 into the pressure and temperature are related as a P1 by T1 is equal to P2 by T2. This is about the Charles law and the Boyle's law. So main the two points about the Boyle's law and the Charles law is in a Boyle's law we are keeping as a temperature as a constant, and we also called as an isothermal process. Iso means same, thermal means temperature. So Boyle's law is the temperature is a constant, P is inversely proportional to the volume. P by V is equal to PV is equal to constant, whereas in terms of a Charles law, Charles law states that what is that constant pressure, the volume of the gas is directly proportional to the absolute temperature, or he also states that at constant volume, the volume of the pressure of the gas is directly proportional to the absolute temperature. So in this the problems are very easy. So we know that the formulas where it's a Boyle's law or Charles law. If it is a given as a temperature constant, we apply the Boyle's law. If they given as a volume or the pressure constant, we apply the Charles law. Work examples based on the Charles law and the Boyle's law. So a gas, when original pressure and volume were 400 kilonewton per meter square and 0.15 meter cube, is expanded until its new pressure is 75 kilonewton per meter square, while its temperature remains constant, what is the new volume? So what is its new volume? So in the problem they given that this temperature remains constant. So itself indicates that system obeys the Boyle's law. So what is the Boyle's law saying? That at constant temperature the pressure is inversely proportional to the volume. So P is inversely proportional to volume. We like to say P is 1 by V. P is proportional to 1 by V. So bring this V to the left side, becomes a PV is equal to, removing the proportionality constant, we can write as a PV is equal to constant. So what is the given data? They given a gas when original pressure. So original pressure and volume. So they given that the P1 and V1. So P1 is equal to 400 kilonewton per meter square and V1 0.15 meter cube. So volume and pressure they given. Until its new pressure is, and they given the new pressure means state 2. So P2 is equal to 75 kilonewton per meter square. What is its new volume? So V2 is equal to constant. So in the problem itself indicates that given that the temperature remains constant. So temperature remains constant means it's obeys the Boyle's law. Boyle's law tells us the pressure is inversely proportional to the volume given data. Since the temperature remains constant, the gas is obeying the Boyle's law. So what's the Boyle's law is saying? That PV is equal to constant. But here in the problem they given that changing the from new state to another state. So we can write this as a P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2. P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2. So in the data, in the problem they given that the P1 V1 and next P2, we have to calculate the V2. So substitute all the values in the equations. So we want only V2. So bring this V2 to the left side and P1 V1 divided by P2. So just cross multiply that. So P2 V2 is equal to P1 V1, nothing but. So we are bringing this P2 to the left side. So then it becomes P1 V1 divided by P2 is equal to V2. So what is the P1 they given? 400. V1 0.15, P2 75. So 0.15 into 400 divided by 75 is equal to 0.8 meter cube. So volume occupied is equal to, new volume occupied is equal to 0.8 meter cube. So this is a problem based on the Boyle's law. So next we move on to the another problem based on the Charles law. based on the Charles example 2. A given mass of gas minus 73 degrees centigrade. So in the Charles law, he states as a this is based on the absolute temperature. Absolute temperature means we have to maintain the minus 73 plus 273. So it gives us to 200 Kelvin. 200 Kelvin exerts a pressure of a 60 centimeters of mercury. So P1 is equal to 60 centimeters of mercury. What is the pressure will exert? So there is a what is the pressure at exert? P2. P2 is equal to question mark. Exert at 27 degrees centigrade. So 27 degrees centigrade means absolute pressure capital T is equal to 27 plus 273 is equal to 300 Kelvin. 200 or 300 Kelvin. If the volume remains constant. So the volume remains constant itself indicates it is in a it's Charles law. Here is the volume. The problem they given is in a volume remains constant. So volume remains constant means at constant volume, the equation between the pressure and the temperature based on the Charles law is pressure is directly proportional to the temperature. The pressure is directly proportional to the temperature. Solution. The given T1, T2, P1. And P2. So we are converting this T1 into absolute pressure. So T1 is equal to minus 73 plus 273 is equal to 200 Kelvin. Like this at T2 also. T2 is equal to 27 plus 273, 300 Kelvin. So according to the Charles law, the volume remains constant. So P1 by T1 is equal to P2 by T2. P1 by T1 is equal to P2 by T2. So in the problem, what they asked? P2. So cross multiplying that. So bring this T2 to the this left side. So it becomes P1 into T2 divided by T1. P1 into T2. P1 this is in a denominator. In the right side, it is in a denominator. If you cross multiply that, it goes to the left side of the numerator. P1 T2 is divided by T1 is equal to P2. So 60 by P2 is equal to 300 by whatever you can do is equal to P2 is equal to 90 centimeters of mercury. Because the P1 is given in the mm of mercury, so P2 also we will get in a mm of mercury. P2 also will get in a mm of mercury. So we are converting into the this is not centimeter, this is also mm of mercury only. 60 into 300, 200 cancel, 23. So it is an mm of mercury, it's not in a centimeters, it is mm only. Mm of mercury. So P2 is equal to 90 centimeters of mercury. So next we go to the, we can write this equation also. P1 by T1 is equal to P1 V1 divided by T1 is equal to P2 V2 divided by T2 is equal to P3 divided by T3 is equal to constant. P1 V1 divided by T1 is a mistake here. So I am writing once again, I am deleting this equation. Just I will write once again, because PV divided by T is equal to constant. So at the two states, so P1 V1 divided by T1 is equal to P2 T2 is equal to constant. P2 V2 is equal to P2 V2 divided by T2 divided by T2 T2. So here also it is in a T1. This also it is in a T1. So P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2 by T2. So this is a characterization. So the constant C is represented by an R is called, and this is a characteristic gas constant having a different values for the different gases. So C, where the C represents as a constant also. But I am removing the C and it can I am replacing the C with a letter capital R. So capital R is called as a characteristic, it's also constant. So but for the different gases it has a different values. So that's why we are called as a characteristic gas equation. Characteristic gas equation. This is the about the characteristic gas equation. PB is equal to RT. PB is equal to RT. So I am writing that R. So you want to know about the R units. So if the mass of the gas is m in kgs, then the above equation can be written as a, if the mass is given in the equation, we can write the equation as a PV is equal to mRT. So the above equation is called the characteristic gas equation. So what is the characteristic gas equation means? We can write the PV is equal to mRT is called as in a characteristic gas equation. PV is equal to mRT is in a characteristic gas equation. Next. So, PV is equal to mRT, where P is the pressure in Newton per meter square, where P is equal to pressure in Newton meter square, MV is the volume, M is equal to mass in kgs, T is the absolute pressure in kgs. If you want the units of R, we want the units of R. So, I am writing that the R is equal to PV by MT, R is equal to PV by MT. For here, P is the pressure. So we all know that the units of the pressure, volume, mass and the temperature. So simply substitute the units in the given units in the above formula. So we know that R is a characteristic gas constant. So to calculate the units of the R, I am writing the R is equal to PV by MT. So where P is equal to Newton per meter square, V is a volume meter cube, mass m kg, T temperature Kelvin, it is in a Kelvin. So here Newton divided by meter square. So meter square is in denominator and meter cube is in numerator. So here 1 meter square here, and meter cube is there. So it's a getting cancelled, remaining is a meter. So whatever is the term remaining in the numerator, Newton meter. And in denominator it is a kg Kelvin, Newton meter divided by kg Kelvin. Or simply we can write as a 1 joule is equal to 1 Newton per meter. So I am writing this Newton meter as a joule. So it is a unit as a joule per kg Kelvin. Joule per kg Kelvin. So the units of the R will be joule per kg Kelvin or kilojoule per kg Kelvin or Newton meter kg Kelvin. Newton meter kg Kelvin. So the we already told that the value of the R is a different for the different gases. The value of a R is different for the different gases. So mostly the in SI units the value of R for the atmospheric air is 287 joule per kg Kelvin. In terms of kilo means we are dividing with 1000, we will get 0.287 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. So we have to remember the atmospheric air, the SI units value of R. R is equal to 0.287 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. If you remember the value in kilojoules, it is 0.287 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. Otherwise, it is a 287 joule per kg Kelvin. 287 joule per kg Kelvin. So, units of the R is equal to joule per kg Kelvin. And what is any characteristic gas equation is nothing but the PV is equal to mRT. So R is equal to characteristic is a characteristic gas constant value. Characteristic gas constant value. So next. So the equation PV is equal to mRT is also expressed in another form, that is in terms of a specific volume. In the terms of a specific volume. So we also know that the specific volume is equal to वॉल्यूम पर मास, वॉल्यूम पर मास. सो पी वी इज इक्वल टू एम आर टी, पी वी इज इक्वल टू एम आर टी. सो आई एम ब्रिंगिंग दिस वॉल्यूम टू द न्यूमरेटर. सो आई एम ब्रिंगिंग, वी नो द फॉर्मुला पी वी इज इक्वल टू एम आर टी. सो आई एम ब्रिंगिंग दिस वॉल्यूम टू द दिस साइड, राइट हैंड साइड, देन इट बिकम्स अ पी इज इक्वल टू एम आर टी बाई वी. सो वी नो दैट द मास बाय वॉल्यूम, सो मास बाय वॉल्यूम इज नथिंग बट द density of density is equal to mass by volume. So simply I am writing as the pressure P is equal to rho RT. Rho, what is the rho? Rho represents the density of gas in terms of a kg per meter cube. So M is a kg, V is a volume, that is meter cube. So if P is in kilonewton per meter square, if the data given in the problem is in kilonewton per meter square, then the R value is also should be in a kilojoule per kg Kelvin. If it is in a kilo Newton per meter square, it is in kilojoule per kg Kelvin. If it is in a pressure, it is in a Newton per meter square, it is a R value should be in a joule per kg Kelvin. So similarly is another form, PV by M in terms of a specific volume. Here I am bringing this M into the left side. In the previously we bring the volume into the right side, now we are bringing this volume into the left side. So PV divided by M is equal to RT, and we can write as a PV is P small v is equal to RT. So small v represents as the specific volume in terms of a meter cube per kg. Specific volume P small v is equal to RT. This is nothing but the specific volume. So the universal gas constant, or we can call it as a molar constant. So it is denoted by the RU. It is denoted by the R suffix U of a gas is the product of the gas constant and the product of the gas constant universal. Previously we discussed about the characteristic gas equation. Now we are discussing about the universal gas constant. So universal gas constant is nothing but the product of the gas constant, product of the gas constant RU and the molecular mass of the gas. So RU, R suffix U, RU is equal to M into R. So this one is very important for the one marks question. What is the universal gas constant? So the universal gas constant or molar constant of the gas is nothing but the product of the gas constant, and M is the molecular mass of the gas. M is the molecular weight. M is the molecular weight of the gas. And R is the gas constant value. So where M is the molecular mass of the gas in kg mole, R is the gas constant. So units of the R should be is kilojoule, because M units we know that joule per kg Kelvin, and M is the molecular mass of the gas in kg mole. So that's why it's the units of RU is equal to joule per kg mole Kelvin or kilojoule per kg mole Kelvin. Kilojoule per mole. In general we can write as a M1R1 is equal to M2R2 is equal to M3R3 is equal to RU. M1R1 is equal to M2R2 is equal to M3R3 is equal to RU. Next, the value of the RU is the same for all the gases. In whereas in the characteristic gas equation, the R value is not same. It is a different for the different gases. But in the case of the universal gas constant, it is the same for all the gases. The SI units of the RU is a the value is a RU value 8.314 kilojoule per kg mole Kelvin. 8.314 kilojoule per kg mole Kelvin. So the characteristic gas equation in terms of a molecular mass we can write PV is equal to MRT, where M is equal to mass of the gas in kg. So I am writing is here equal to M is equal to mass of the kg, PV is equal to NMRT. N is equal to number of moles, M is equal to molecular weight. So we can write as is a PV is equal to. So ideal gas equations is all the two problems. So first one, air at initial pressure of 1.3 bar has specific volume 0.9 meter cube per kg and the temperature is 135 degree centigrade. Find the gas constant. Find the gas constant. So what's the air at initial pressure? So air at initial pressure is P1. P1 is equal to 1.3 bar and the specific volume. Specific volume we are represented with the small v. Small v is equal to 0.9 meter cube per kg. And the temperature, we have to convert this temperature into the absolute temperature. So capital T is equal to 135 plus 273. Find the gas constant. Find the gas constant. So pressure 1.3 bar means 1.3 into 10 square. So 1 bar is equal to 10 to the power of 5 newton per meter square. So all remember that in the first class we discussed the conversion of a pressure. So 1 bar is equal to 10 to the power of 5 newton per meter square. So here I am writing as in terms of a kilonewton per meter square. So that's why in the 10 power 5 I am writing as a 10 square only. So remaining 10 power 3 I am representing with a kilo. So 1.3 into 10 square is nothing but the 100. So 10 power 3 is nothing but the kilo. 10 power 3 means kilo. So it is a 1.3 into 100 kilonewton per meter square. Kilonewton per meter square. Next, specific volume. The specific volume is denoted by a small v, and it is given as a 0.9 meter cube per kg. So, sir, temperature T is equal to 135 degree centigrade. So, we have to convert the temperature into the absolute temperature. It is a 135 plus 273 is equal to 408 Kelvin. 408 Kelvin. So, gas constant R. So, in the problem they asked about the gas constant. So, gas constant is nothing but the R. R is equal to question mark. Calculate the R value. So, from the characteristic gas equation, we know that the PV is equal to MRT. So, from characteristic gas equation, we know that the gas equation PV is equal to MRT, where P is the pressure, V is the volume, M is the mass in kgs, R is equal to, where R is equal to characteristic gas equation, T is the temperature. So, we want, in the problem they asked to calculate about the R value. So, I am bringing these, putting the R into the left side and remaining terms into the right side. PV divided by MT. PV divided by MT. So, in the problem, they deem given that the volume and the mass, simply they given it is a specific volume. Simply they given as a specific volume. The specific volume is nothing but the volume of the fluid by the mass of the fluid. So, it is represented with a small v. So, I am writing this equation in the form of a small v, specific volume P divided by T. So, in the problem they given the specific value, pressure value and temperature value and temperature. So, by using the calculator, we calculate this, calculate the above solution, we will get the R value. So, R value we will get in terms of a kilojoules only, because here we are taking the pressure in kilonewton per meter square. That's why we will get the final answer also kilojoule per kg Kelvin, kilojoule per kg. Another example. So, another example means, based of the problem related to the universal gas constant. Universal gas constant. So, carbon dioxide gas at a 25 degree centigrade and 101.3 kilopascals has a density of 1.799 kg per meter cube. So, determine the gas constant and molecular weight. So, carbon dioxide gas. So, temperature T is equal to 25 plus 273. 25 plus 273 and the pressure P is equal to 101.3 kilopascals, density 1.799 kg per meter cube. So, determine solution. Pressure P, temperature T, density rho. So, they ask the gas constant R value and the molecular weight M value. They ask the gas constant R value and the molecular weight M value. So, in the problem, they given the pressure, temperature, density, gas constant and molecular weight. From the characteristic gas equation, I am writing as a PV is equal to MRT. PV is equal to MRT. From that, I am writing, in the problem they given, it is a density. So, I am writing this equation in the form of a density. So, I am bringing this volume to the right side, then the mass by volume will become the density. So, PV is equal to P is equal to rho RT. But in the problem, they ask you to calculate the R value. So R, put R here and bring the remaining to the left side. So it becomes P divided by RT, divided by RT. So be careful while doing the cross multiplication. So if you reverse the rho T by, if you reverse these values, so we don't get the correct answer. So while writing the, while doing the cross multiplications, be careful because so many students did mistake here only. So R is equal to P by rho T. So we know the P value, rho value, T value. So we will get the R value. So after getting the R value, we will get the RU value. RU is equal to M into R. Universal gas strength RU is equal to MU. So you know that the R value, and we all know that the molecular weight of the molecular weight is equal to molecular weight of this. So 44 RU M is equal to, you want to calculate the MU, M is equal to RU by R. So RU, you got the RU is the constant value 8.314 divided by 0.188. So it is a 44 kg per mole. So after getting the universal gas constant by after getting the characteristic gas equation R, by using the universal gas constant formula, RU is equal to MR. So RU is nothing but the universal gas constant. RU is equal to is the product of a molecular weight into R value. So you want only M value. So M is equal to RU divided by R. Next, M, we want the M value. So RU is a constant value 8.314. We know that the RU value 8.314 divided by R value we got as a 0.188 is a 44 kg mole. So this is the problems regarding the ideal gas equations and the real gas equations. It's a in the next class we will discuss about the Joule's law, Avogadro's number, and some problems related to the Joule's law and the Avogadro's numbers, and Regnault's law also. So we will do some problems in this based on the laws. So thank you. So in the next class we will discuss about the remaining laws. We will discuss about the remaining laws. Thank you. So summary means we discussed about the perfect gas laws, Boyle's laws, and the Charles laws, and the characteristic gas equations, and the universal gas constant.